Welcome to Allergy and Asthma Network's Patient Learning Pathways program. Today's program takes a look at allergy shots as a part of allergen immunotherapy. What is immunotherapy? Allergy immunotherapy, or AIT, helps build a patient's tolerance to allergens, which can reduce or eliminate symptoms. There are two kinds of allergy immunotherapy: shots, or SCIT, which stands for subcutaneous immunotherapy, and allergy tablets, or SLIT-T, an abbreviation for sublingual immunotherapy tablets. Here's how it works. The patient is given a gradually increasing amount of the allergen on a regular schedule until a maintenance level is reached and symptoms are relieved. Tolerance for the allergen typically continues after AIT ends, but the long-term success varies from person to person. We talk about allergy tablets in another Patient Learning Pathways program. To have the full picture of immunotherapy options, be sure to learn about allergy tablets, or SLIT-T. The first dose of immunotherapy is given in the doctor's office to watch for signs of a life-threatening allergic reaction, or anaphylaxis. While there is a slight risk of experiencing an allergic reaction, the patient should have access to epinephrine, the life-saving medication for anaphylaxis, and seek emergency treatment if necessary. The second dose for tablets are administered at home, but all allergy shots are given in the doctor's office. Allergy shots, or subcutaneous immunotherapy, known as SCIT, are the most familiar form of immunotherapy. Often, several different allergens can be combined into one injection, helping to build tolerance to more than one allergen at once. SCIT has been proven to be effective for pollens, mold, animal dander, house dust mites, cockroach allergens, and insect venom. The allergy shots many help prevent new allergies and stop the progression of allergic diseases. They can also help control allergic asthma by interrupting the allergic response that sets off symptoms. Age is not a barrier to starting allergy shots. How does SCIT work? Shots are given at a board-certified allergist's office once or twice monthly for about 6 to 12 months. The allergist increases the level of allergen extract given in the shots until the maintenance dose is reached. The doctor will decide with the patient how often shots will continue after that time. Often, people will be able to stop the AIT and still have some protection after 3 to 5 years. SCIT is given in the doctor's office in order to be able to watch for signs of a life-threatening allergic reaction, or anaphylaxis. While this is rare, the patient needs to have access to epinephrine, a life-saving medication. Anaphylaxis requires emergency treatment. Many people have a long-lasting reduction of symptoms when receiving SCIT. It's important to realize that allergies can change over time, especially if the patient moves to a new environment, a new home, or a new workplace. If the patient has completed their course of SCIT and symptoms return, it's important to talk to the doctor. It might not be old allergies returning, it may be new allergies that have developed. Thank you for joining us for this Allergy and Asthma Network Patient Learning Pathways presentation. Allergy and Asthma Network is working every day to end the needless death and suffering due to asthma, allergies, and related conditions through outreach, education, advocacy, and research. Please join us for another Patient Learning Pathways presentation as we partner with you to breathe better together.